Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus. I'm your host, GrandPyromania, and on the previous episode, we managed to get the last two keys, and I found out I apparently didn't do the first two levels of this stage, so I went ahead and did that off screen, and in this episode, we will be going to Sir Raleigh's with a limp thingamajigger by use of this cannon. And that's all seven keys. So, bonsai!
How delightful! We have a guest. The only thing is,
I hate unexpected guests!
Listen, Raleigh, wipe up my family and steal what's mine, you better expect company.
Oh, I'm ever so sorry. How sloppy of me not to finish the job. Obviously, we should have snuffed you out as well. So, without further ado, let me make amends by what?
Bloating to gargantuan size and squashing you like the insignificant bug that you are.
Bring it on.
Yeah, so, Sir Raleigh, it just turned into a giant blimp. Oh, geez. And that is not a good way to start off this thing here. Alright, so the general strategy is when he, like, deflates like that, right? That's when you want to attack him, so you kind of got to stay, like, basically on the same platform as him. And let's see, yeah, we could just sort of do this. You could just sort of run under him, and then when he does that, you can just hit him, and he will lose quite a bit of HP. Alright, now we only have this platform, so we basically just do what I was just doing, which is running to where he was before he jumps, and what? I hit him! Oh, come on, game, that isn't even fair. I totally hit him there, and it bounced me off. Oh, PS2 games, thou with slightly glitchy. Oh, well. Well, at least I got him in, so we need to hit him about two or three more times, so that's not too bad here. And now, every time he hits on a platform, right, he will be making the platform sink, which is never a good thing. Come on, there we go. Yeah, I figured it was coming up soon because he only has like four or five jumps before he completely deflates. So that's a generally a good marker to go on. And whoa. Okay, so now we gotta play like a weird game of jump rope. And this time,
blast it all! You've beaten me.
Well, gloat all you want, Sly Cooper. You're no match for Muggshot, my villainous cohort in Utah. You will see. Mesa City is so well guarded, a snake couldn't slither in without setting off alarms.
Raleigh's section of the Thievius Raccoonus held detailed instructions on how to perform my ancestor Ryoichi Cooper's Ninja Spire Jump, a technique he developed while sneaking into the thickly fortified castles of feudal Japan. Finding a way off Raleigh's boat got a little tricky with the untimely arrival of Inspector Fox, who, failing to find me, busted Raleigh and his crew. With the storm machine out of commission, boats found their way back onto the ocean, and the mystery of the Welsh Triangle faded from memory. My gang and I loafed around England for a while, enjoying the pleasant weather, and then headed back home, excited for our next heist.
Alright, so we beat Tide of Terror, so guys, we're going to Utah.
It had been a while since I'd been back in the U.S. Next up, the notorious Muggshot, ruthless muscle of the Fiendish Five. What he lacked in brains, he definitely made up for in brawn. Turns out he wasn't always that way. He grew up as the run of the litter. A neighborhood weakling. The only friends he could turn to were usually found on the big screen. It was there that he spotted his first gangster, and he knew instantly that that's what he wanted to be. He spent the rest of his youth working real hard to get there, fueled on his dreams of great power and respect. With enough perspiration, he realized that dream. He'd become a hard-boiled, street-brawling, tough-as-nails gangster, ensuring that he'd never be kicked on or pushed around again. So he's holed up in Mesa City, huh? I've always wanted to go to that thriving American boomtown.
Sly Cooper in Sunset! Snake Eyes!
Alright, so we're here in Utah, and of course, right off the bat, we got two of these wonderful bottles and the message that we can, you know, take so that way our good buddy Bentley can...
Hey, Sly, I thought you said Mesa City was going to be loud and busy. This looks more like a ghost town.
Something's happened. Where is everyone?
I don't know, but it's starting to give me the creeps. What do you say we take off?
And miss all the fun? Besides, I want to try out that new move I got from Raleigh's section of the Thievius Raccoonus.
You mean the ninja spire jump?
Yeah. Do me a favor and read me the instructions again.
To landeth safely upon diminutive points, leapeth lively and presseth the triggering device with the round geometrical object emblazoned upon it.
So jump and hit the circle button to land on narrow spots.
That's a rough translation.
Alright, so as I was saying, we need to get these bottles so that our good friend Bentley can, of course, decode them. And let me just say, the bottles in this level, particularly, in my opinion, are actually kind of tricky, because a lot of them are good at hiding, and hiding bottles are always just the meanest of the mean. Now let's just go ahead and get this one. Alright, 7. So, we have 40. I believe this is actually the most we have yet to have to... capture, and of course I would fall to the ground. Okay, so let's just go ahead and use our new move, which lets us basically just jump onto these little platforms. All right, now we got a new type of enemy here, and it's a mad dog, and he will slobber and attack you, but unfortunately for him, he is stuck to that leash. I don't know why he would be, but hey, I'm not Muggshot. I don't do things the way he does. Like, if it was me, I would probably let them go wild. But then again, this is why I'm not Muggshot. Alright, let's just go ahead and get some of these bottles here. And, you know, do some platforming, which I'm surprised I haven't messed up yet. But now that I've said that I'm surprised I haven't messed up, I'm probably gonna mess up. And, oh, okay, that was a bit close, but hey. Alright, so let's just go ahead and climb up here and use that to catapult across, and basically a good way to attack these guys is either if they get pushed, yeah, basically when they get pulled back to their like leash pull thing, then that's generally a really good time to strike. Am I missing any so far?
What's with those flashing lights?
The latest in high-tech security. Electronic floor sensors. Step on them and you're a goner.
Nice touch.
They're safe to walk on while flashing, but it also means they're about to switch to a different sector.
Alright, so as I was saying before, Bentley so rudely explained a game mechanic that we needed to know. Gosh, Bentley, what do you want us to succeed or something? Yeah, like, my first playthrough of this, jeez, come on. Yeah, my first playthrough of this, right, I actually missed the bottle, or like, it actually took me like a very, not a very long time, but like a considerable amount of time trying to get all the bottle pieces, so I will endeavor to try to help you guys as much as, whoa, dude, stop throwing your chain and ball at me. I do not want to have your chain of balls all over me. No, sir, I don't want your chain of balls. All right, let's just go ahead and do that. And hey, we got another one of those walrus things that throws stuff, except in this case, it's a dog that throws playing cards. Now, I'll never understand this game, but just because I won't doesn't mean you don't have to. I don't know where I was going with that, but so really easy to miss bottles are down here. This is one of just the many, and Sly, dang it, Sly! Come on, I can't be. Okay, cool. Okay, I was slightly freaking, not freaking out, but like I was slightly worried that I'd have to restart everything and that would not be, whoa, there are two mad dogs here. But luckily we can take him out and I just hit him into the canyon. I should feel bad about this, but surprisingly enough, I really don't. Maybe I'm just a bad person. That's also a distinct possibility. All right, so let's just go ahead and make our way through there. Oh, I see you over there yonder. And whoa, dude, Sly, you are not a driver. That is Murray's job. All right, take you down. You know, for bursting through the walls like that, you think they'd go faster, get the element of surprise, but it's kind of easy to react and, you know, junk when you're moving really slowly. Now, well, it's not my job to train them properly or improperly. Alright, so we got, of course, the standard security system here, and just sort of make our way through here, and there we go. There's our first security system down. Let's just jump over here, and oh, well, this just makes life just so much more fun. Oh, goodness gracious! How did I trip that? Did not think I actually tripped that. Alright. Okay, so let's just go over here, and yeah, I actually think I missed. Wow. I missed a lot. Sick. Okay, no, there are two more over here. Meaning, I still missed four. See, this is what I mean. It's really, really easy to sort of miss everything. So, I'm actually just gonna go ahead and try to get the rest off screen. So, I'll be back. Or, not off screen, but I'll look for them and then I'll show you guys where they are. So, I'll be right back. Okay, so let me just say there's one right here. I have no idea how I missed that, but apparently I just kept on walking by. I will see you guys back when I find the other three. Okay, I found the other three. Again, I have no idea how I managed to miss them, but yeah, I did. So, you know. Oh, okay, apparently I can't clap. Why? Game. You guys saw that, right? I mean, I'm not crazy, right? Okay. So, let's see. How am I gonna get on there? Could I actually go up here? It's sad because, like, I've gotten all of them before, right? I just have bad selective memory when it comes to these things. There we go. Apparently, I just went at the wrong angle on the last part. Alright, well, let's just go ahead and get that horseshoe and climb up here because we have all 40 out of 40. Yeah, basically the four I missed were on that thing, and like past beyond that tunnel there's actually a little side path, so
press the circle, yeah, to enter the vault code. A little bit of higher mathematics and voila, dial in 314.
All right, so the question, so the answer is pi. 3-1-4.
Outstanding! You've uncovered Rob McCooper's patented explosive hat technique. Use the triangle button to toss your cap, then use the triangle button again to detonate it. Better back off to a safe distance first.
Okay, so we're back here. Let's go ahead and get the key. And we're gonna be going through and beating this stage level thing. Alright. So, welcome to Muggshot's Turf. Now, let's just go through this little winding tunnel and not fail horrendously as soon as we get in. Okay.
This mugshot certainly isn't shy. Okay, so we know he's here somewhere, but how are we supposed to find him? Mesa City is a big place.
Given that he's a bulldog, it seems only reasonable to assume that he chose to live in a giant fire hydrant.
That's some sound logic, Sly. Now you just need to find a way to break into the building's base.
Oh, I'm sure I'll think of something.
Alright, so, in the next episode, we will be, of course, tackling all the stages here to get the keys in order to send that car. Let me just get a better angle of it. Get that car, a Revan, a break through that giant fire hydrant. Yeah. So, this is GrandPyromania signing out. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time for some more Let's Play Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus.